Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chonzom. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Thursday, the 2nd of July. India's first plasma bank for COVID-19 treatment inaugurated in New Delhi. Government workers protest for job regularization in Gilgit-Baltistan. And residents clang utensils to drive away locusts in Nepal's Kathmandu. And now for all the details. India's first plasma bank was inaugurated in capital New Delhi on Thursday as authorities appeal to all those who can donate plasma to come forward and help in treatment for critical coronavirus patients. The move comes as plasma therapy has shown encouraging results in Delhi hospitals. India's first plasma bank was inaugurated in capital New Delhi on Thursday by Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal as he appealed to all those who can donate plasma to come forward and help in treatment for critical coronavirus patients. The plasma bank has been set up at the Delhi government-run Institute of Liver and Biliary Sciences or ILBS Hospital. Delhi remains the third worst-hit region in the country with over 89,800 positive cases of coronavirus. In plasma therapy, the antibodies from the recovered person's body are administered into a patient's body. The move comes as convalescent plasma therapy has shown encouraging results in city hospitals.
Abhi corona ka koi vaccine to nahi aaya, lekin plasma therapy ek tarah se kafi madadgar sabit hoti hai logon ko is bimari mein. Hum ye to nahi kahenge ki isse sabko सारी डेथ जीरो की जा सकती है लेकिन फिर भी हमें उम्मीद है अभी तक जो नतीजे आए हैं प्लाज्मा थेरेपी के कि ये काफी मददगार साबित होती है और
मीनवाइल इंडियाज कोरोना वायरस इन्फेक्शन सरपास 600,000 ऑन थर्सडे विद 17,834 डेथ्स एज अथॉरिटीज बैटल टू कंटेन द पैंडेमिक व्हाइल ईजिंग लॉकडाउन रूल्स डिस्पाइट राइजिंग केसेस. An easing phase called Unlock 2 was announced on Monday, allowing more economic activities to resume. Former US Ambassador to the UN Nikki Haley has hailed India's action to ban 59 apps linked to Chinese firms, including TikTok, and said New Delhi is continuing to show it will not back down from China's aggression. Haley's remarks come after US Secretary of State Mike Pompeo also welcomed India's move.
Former US Ambassador to the United Nations Nikki Haley has heaped praises on the Indian government's move to ban 59 Chinese apps, including the popular TikTok, in retaliation to Chinese aggression. Nikki Haley has said, "Good to see India banning 59 popular apps owned by Chinese firms, including TikTok, which counts India as one of its largest markets. India is continuing to show it won't back down from China's aggression." Haley's remarks come after US Secretary of State Mike Pompeo welcomed India's ban on the Chinese apps and stressed that the move would boost India's integrity and national security. The Indian government on Monday announced that it had decided to block 59 apps, including TikTok, in view of the information available that they are engaged in activities which are prejudicial to sovereignty and integrity of India, defense of India, the security of the state, and public order. The move came weeks after a deadly skirmish between Indian and Chinese soldiers along the disputed Himalayan border.
The coronavirus tally in Pakistan reached 217,809 with the detection of 4,339 new cases in the last 24 hours on Thursday. As healthcare in Pakistan continues to suffer from acute shortage of resources amid coronavirus crisis, healthcare residents continue to fume at government response to the pandemic. Amid coronavirus pandemic, healthcare in Pakistan continues to suffer from coordination challenges and an acute shortage of resources. Pakistan's confirmed COVID-19 cases jumped past 217,000 as 4,339 persons tested positive for COVID-19 in the last 24 hours. The death toll crossed 4,400 on Thursday. Residents in Pakistan's Karachi city allege that authorities pocketed huge amounts of funds meant for the treatment of patients and charged exorbitantly for coronavirus treatment. Thousands of people even lost their jobs and businesses during the lockdown, but no aid was provided to them by the government.
लेकिन इसमें अचानक ही वबा फैली और इतनी तेजी से फैली कि हम लोगों को संभलने का मौका ही नहीं मिल सका। इसके बावजूद के हमारी हुकूमत ने मुख्तलिफ दूसरे मुल्कों से कर्जे माफ कराए और इमदाद हासिल की, लेकिन बदकिस्मती से वो जो भी वहाँ से इमदाद मिली थी वो आवाम तक मुंतकिल नहीं हुई, क्योंकि जो लोग हुकूमतों में होते हैं वो अपने इलेक्शनों का खर्चा निकालने के लिए जब भी कोई फंड सामने आए तो उसको मिस अप्रोप्रिएट करते हैं।
They blamed that authorities who have forever acted callously in matters of development didn't bother to address even this grave health crisis. Meanwhile, the Sindh government on Wednesday extended the curbs on business and other activities of daily life which were imposed to contain the coronavirus for another 15 days, directing the people across the province to follow the defined standard operating procedures.
Moving on, contractual employees serving in different government departments in Gilgit-Baltistan recently carried out a protest demanding job regularization. The protesters blame the authorities have kept on delaying the process for the past several years.
Several contractual employees serving in different government departments in illegally occupied Gilgit-Baltistan region recently held a protest against a Pakistani establishment seeking regularization of their jobs. Gilgit-Baltistan Assembly in May passed a bill to regularize the services of thousands of contractual and contingent staff in Gilgit-Baltistan who have been in service for past several years. The protesters who gathered outside the Secretariat office, however, blamed the authorities are delaying the process.
जिस माशरे के अंदर 6,000 मुलाजमीन कंट्रैक्ट और कंटीजन हो, जिनके अंदर एंग्जाइटी हो और तशवीश का शिकार हो और वो इस शुबे का शिकार हो कि हमारा मुस्तकबिल क्या होगा, आप वहाँ के इदारों की कारकर्दगी के बारे में बेहतर जान सकते हैं कि इदारों की क्या क्या कारकर्दगी होगी, और इसी वजह से जो हमारे डिपार्टमेंट है वो 5 साल पीछे 10 साल पीछे चले जाते हैं।
हमारे हम सब का मुतालबा यही है कि हमें फौरी तौर पर रेगुलर किया जाए, न करने की सूरत में हम यहाँ पे इससे भी बढ़कर हम 6,000 मुलाजमीन हैं, हम सारे इकट्ठे होकर एक प्लेटफार्म से जो है ना हम शदीद एहतजाज करेंगे।
Locals and government workers have to often hit the streets to demand even their basic rights. The illegally occupied region has also been swept by a wave of dissent in the last few months due to negligence amid coronavirus pandemic. People have not just been seeking their rights but challenging the decades-old suppressive status quo.
U.S. Secretary of State Mike Pompeo said on Wednesday that the United States correctly handled reported intelligence that Russia was paying bounties to Taliban-affiliated militants to kill U.S. soldiers in terms of the protection of U.S. troops.
The United States handled correctly reported intelligence that Russia was paying bounties to Taliban-affiliated militants to kill U.S. soldiers in terms of the protection of U.S. troops, U.S. Secretary of State Mike Pompeo said on Wednesday. However, speaking to reporters, Pompeo did not explicitly confirm the intelligence which has been widely reported in the media, nor did he address whether U.S. President Donald Trump was made aware of it. After Trump initially said he was not briefed on the matter, the White House said Trump was not personally briefed but did not address whether he had received a written report, read it, and why he had not responded more aggressively if so.
I can assure you that whatever reporting it is that you're referring to, that we responded in precisely the correct way with respect to making sure that our forces were postured appropriately, that they were aware of the level of the threat, the credibility of the threat, and that we were there. Second, the fact that the Russians are engaged in Afghanistan in a way that's adverse to the United States is nothing new.
Pompeo also said that Russia has been acting in ways contrary to U.S. interests in Afghanistan for a decade, including by selling small arms that put U.S. soldiers at a risk. He said it was up to Trump whether to invite Russian President Vladimir Putin to a Group of Seven or G7 summit, saying that Russia caused problems when it was in the group, still presents risks, and he believed it was important to have more frequent dealings with Moscow.
In news from Nepal, swarms of locusts invaded Nepal's capital Kathmandu, prompting residents to bang utensils to ward off the crop-destroying swarms. Residents braced themselves after an alert from the authorities and were seen banging utensils to scare away the locusts this week.
Swarms of locusts reached Nepal this week and people came out to their rooftops and clanged utensils to scare the locusts away. Locals in Balajutar in capital Kathmandu resorted to the clanging of utensils and tin cans to bursting firecrackers in a bid to chase them away. Nepal reported the first spotting of locust in some districts bordering India. As it is after six decades the locust entered the Himalayan nation, for many people it was the first encounter with locusts.
This is the first time I have seen it. This is the first time I have seen it in my life. अब पहिले पहिले त मकैमा लाग्ने फौजी किराहरू चाहिँ देखिएको थियो अब अहिले सलाकेर चाहिँ फर्स्ट टाइम देखिरहेको मैले चाहिँ
वन अफ द डेडलीएस्ट पेस्ट फर फार्म प्रड्युस लोकस्ट आर नोन टु डेस्ट्रोय क्रप्स एन्ड भेजिटेबल्स एन्ड वाट एभर दे फाइन्ड इन दियर वे इन सर्च अफ फुड
त्यस्तो डर लाग्ने त अब खासै भएन अब सुनिएको थियो थाहा भएको थियो नि त अब भनौँ समाचार न्युजहरूबाट पनि थाहा थियो आउँदैछ आछ भन्ने कुरो त्यस्तो डर त भएन हेर्दाखेरि चाहिँ ठ्याक्कै फट्याङ्ग्रो जस्तो आकार हुँदो रहेछ क्या त्यसको ठुलै साइज त हो आखिर त्यस्तो डर चाहिँ भएन अनुभव चाहिँ
A working committee formed by the government of Nepal to study the movement of the locust has claimed that the swarm entered the capital from the southern direction of Kathmandu. The committee has estimated the number of locusts to be over 1,000. Seeing the destruction of crops, various local bodies and organizations have started announcing bounty for the locusts.
Sikh devotees mark the foundation day of Akal Takht, the temporal body of Sikhs in India's northern Amritsar city on Wednesday. They offered prayers and sang hymns to mark the occasion.
Sikh devotees in Amritsar city of India's northern Punjab province marked the foundation day of Akal Takht, the temporal body of Sikhs, on Wednesday. Situated in the complex of Golden Temple, Sikhism's holy shrine, the Akal Takht was established in the year 1606 during Mughal rule by the sixth Sikh Guru, Guru Hargobind Sahib, as a place where temporal issues of the community members could be taken into consideration. Devotees gathered at the Akal Takht to offer prayers and attend the ceremony where hymns were sung and respects were paid to the holy book Guru Granth Sahib to mark the auspicious occasion.
ਮੇਰੀ ਪੀਰੀ ਦੇ ਮਾਲਕ ਸ੍ਰੀ ਹਰਗੋਬਿੰਦ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਮਹਾਰਾਜ ਜੀ ਦਾ ਸਥਾਪਿਤ ਕੀਤਾ ਹੋਇਆ ਸ੍ਰੀ ਅਕਾਲ ਤਖਤ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਦੀ ਅੱਜ ਸਥਾਪਨਾ ਦਿਵਸ ਦੀਆਂ ਸਮੂਹ ਸੰਗਤਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਬਹੁਤ ਬਹੁਤ ਵਧਾਈਆਂ
Sikhs in India form about 2% of over 1.25 billion population and are largely concentrated in the northern Indian state of Punjab and national capital New Delhi.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/asianewsline and follow us on Twitter at asianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button. Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.